what I believe. Something is broken and twisted and pushed away. No one is listening. What have we done? I'll put the empty out, darkness and lonely again.
Through the Current, you are listening to Gary Numan live here in our studios. Welcome to Minnesota, Gary. Do you want to introduce who's all in the band here?
Okay. On keyboards, we have Aid Fenton, who also produced the new record. On bass, we have Tim Muddyman over there. On guitar, Steve Harris. And in the drum booth there on drums is Richard Beasley.
We're all color coordinated here, but it's obvious that none of you own dogs or cats because I don't see a single ounce of pet hair on any one of you except me. So, or do you have lint rollers on the tour bus?
Oh, we just don't bring the animals with us.
Okay. How was the show last night?
It was very good, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, the whole tour has been, from our point of view, has been fantastic.
People receiving the new music well.
That's what's most encouraging.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, for a long time, people were waiting for certain songs. And we seem to have crossed that bridge now. And now we have people who are singing along to new stuff who are clearly not singing along to the old stuff. And for me, that's a huge leap forward.
With any artist, I think as you change and as you grow and your music changes, you want your audience to change and grow with you and to follow what direction you're going in. And that must be a great reward to have that feeling.
It is, although I think it's probably more to do with new people coming in than the older people come. There's some of that, obviously, but I think anyone that's been around for a long time, there is a natural falling off of the end, if you like. You know, people get older, they get children, they get mortgages, they get promoted, and they don't have the time or the inclination, perhaps, to spend, you know, the amount of thought that they put into music before and money that they had into it before. And so they just kind of fall off a little bit as they get older. So you need new people coming in.
Yeah.
Which tends to mean younger people coming in that have still got that time and drive to be involved in music.
Does it feel weird to you at all, though, that music you made over 25 years ago is influencing band sound today?
It does, actually. Yeah, I mean, it's very lovely, and I'm very proud of it. It's quite a cool thing, but it is surprising. All the more so when, you know, I remember what I was thinking when I wrote that stuff, and
right.
You just panicking, trying to get it as good as you can get it. And the last thing you're thinking of is that this is going to be influential or innovative in some way. You're just trying to do the best you can at any given time. But that's been true of every album I've ever made.
I know I've read that you had maybe said previously that in the earlier days, do you feel like your career was a little mismanaged?
By me?
By you?
My entire career has been mismanaged by me. I've done an incredibly bad job, I think, over the years. I've done all the wrong things.
How have you screwed up?
Oh, God, got a list of A to Z. I could be here a long time.
Mm-hmm.
It, but just touring at the wrong times, in the wrong places, being with the wrong labels, making the wrong albums, too long gaps between them at times, too many at other times. Honestly, I could go on forever.
Well, I know that, you know, for a while there you kind of retired from performing, but you never really stopped recording.
No, I wanted to calm everything down. When it first happened for me, in Britain especially, it was pretty much overnight, you know, literally. So it changes every part of your life. And it's not all good. And some of it you just take time to get used to. But it's all going at 1,000 miles an hour.
Yeah.
And you just feel like you're being smashed along, but you know, and I just wanted to calm everything down. I wanted to understand what had happened, and it felt like a survival thing as much as anything. And so, in my sort of childishness, I guess I tended to blame it all on touring, because that seemed to put you in front of everybody. That's where all the horrible reviews were coming from, and the hostility from the press, and all that stuff that at that time was bad. Much better now, luckily. And so I just backed out of it. Very sensible thing to do. The stupid thing I did was make a great big song and dance about it. I should have just quietly done it, backed out and took a breath, understood where I was, and then come back in. And I didn't. I have to make this great big "I'm going to retire" announcement, which is just stupid. It upset the business people. The record companies got annoyed at me and dropped me. And the fans got offended and disappeared in their tens of thousands. And I've been sort of trying to make up for that particular mistake ever since, I think.
How sensitive were you to reviews and such at the time?
Well, I've got Asperger's, so in a way I'm able to kind of disconnect from it a little bit. I have a very highly developed sense of focus, so I'm able to just push through all that sort of stuff. It bothers you for about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And then you forget about it.
And then you let it go.
Yeah.
Good. Well, let's get another song and we'll chat some more. What do you want to play?
We're going to do a song that's called Metal.
All right.